today. From Lambeau Field in Green Bay, Wisconsin, it's the NFC Championship Game.
This is what I'm talking about. NFL playoffs at Lambeau Field with a snowstorm camped out over the upper Midwest. Let's go. It's time for some great football in Green Bay. Coming up, it's a battle to represent the NFC in this year's Super Bowl. And we've got a classic in store between the Tampa Bay Buccaneers and the Green Bay Packers. With Charles Davis, as always, I'm Brandon Gaudin. Charles, you talk about storylines in this one. I think it begins and ends with our two quarterbacks, certainly two of the best in the business.
And nowadays, I don't think you can get by for long periods of time without a top-flight quarterback. The way the game is played, with all the responsibility he has and how the game flows through him, if he's not on the top of his game, your team's not going to benefit at all.
Tampa Bay coming out along with a man who needs no introduction, the great Tom Brady.
And Tom Brady is personally trying to do something that's never been done, and that's go to the Super Bowl for a 10th time. This will be the first time in a Tampa Bay Buccaneers uniform and just a second trip to the Super Bowl in franchise history. Tom Brady in championship games, conference championship games, 9-4 all time. So if you're thinking about the pressure getting to him, think again. He's handled it.
Under a heavy rush, and down he goes. The number one mission of any offensive line, you got to protect that quarterback, keep him safe back there. This time, the rush got to him in a hurry.
And this came from the edge, and those pass rushers, they have so many tricks of the trade to get around blockers. They have a lot of tools in their kit. This was pure speed and athleticism on this play, though, and they could barely get a glove on him before he got the quarterback on the ground.
And as we check the next-gen stats, that play lasted just 2.7 seconds from beginning to end. Just not enough time to throw the football. After the sack on first down, Brady, he'll find Miller. That's complete. Just a one-yard loss that time, but that's not what they needed. Now they're dealing with a third and long.
Well, I know it goes against the instincts of the person catching the ball, because all you're ever taught is catch the football, don't drop it.
But drop it there.
Yeah, in that situation, dropping it would have been better. End up losing yardage, even though they completed the pass.
As good as a sack.
Yeah, how about that? And although they won't get the same credit for it, and it won't help them at contract time.
Incomplete on the drop. That's one he definitely normally catches. Fourth down. The punt team on now as Pinion sends this one away. It'll be a 45-yard punt, and couple that with a loss on the return. And it'll be Packer football here, first down and 10. So here comes the Packers offense now onto the field. Under center is a 6'2", 225-pound signal caller, Aaron Rodgers.
And we can talk all we want about football being a team game and leaning on different parts and aspects in order to get it done. And that's entirely true during the regular season. Some weeks it's the defense, the special teams, running the football. But in the playoffs, all the pressure reverts to the quarterback, and he has to play well. Team
15 yards is the pickup there, and the drive starting very nicely. First down.
Usually we see runs like this as the defense breaks down later in the game, but this guy's setting the tone early, running through all types of tackles and put the defense back on its heels.
First down is Rodgers. He gets this to Devontae Adams. And able to work this to the 25 before it's all said and done. It's another first down, and that'll be a gain of 21 yards.
I don't care who you put on him, he's going to be a handful in one-on-one throws. close.
Yeah, right now, you're right. They're in man-to-man, maybe need some safety help.
I would say that'd be a good idea. Double team him somehow. I'm going to have to make someone else beat me rather than let him shred my defense.
Give him a couple on the carry there. Second and 8.
Oh, that's a real nice job there by the defensive front. They just engaged and held their ground. But how about the guy who made the play? We often talk about whether they take a good first step or not. Many times you just don't take any step. Just get your feet moving, get your body going. And then once he made the read, he was able to make the play.
4 yards on the completion, and it sets up a third down. Working from the gun, Rodgers. Inside the 5. And the Packers are going to have first and goal as they try to finish off this drive with 6 points. His first catch in this NFC Championship game, and it's a first down.
His passing's been on point on this drive, hasn't it? Been very accurate, gotten the ball downfield, gained nice chunks of yardage. But now, in this situation, the field is really condensed, partner. So if he's going to throw the football, that'd be pinpoint here.
As I was going to ask you about that. Field shrinks, has to be sharper, but it's been a good opening drive so far.
Now they just want to see if they can cap it off with the bell ringer and put it in the end zone.
And he's going to take it in. Touchdown, Packers. Taking it in for 4 yards out. And the Packers have taken the early lead. One of the keys to their long winning streak has been scoring first. An ideal drive right there, getting the first 6 points of the ballgame.
With some teams, I script to probe in the early part of the game. Other teams, I script to attack. They've been in attack mode for these ball games and continue that in this one.
On is Mason Crosby for the point after. This afternoon, but this one is good. So the drive there took 6 plays, and it results in a 4-yard touchdown run. Now after the touchdown, here's Crosby to kick it away. Fielded a couple yards into the end zone. And he'll wind up getting a couple extra yards here for his trouble and bringing it out of the end zone as he's down at the 27.
27-yard line.
Tampa Bay, they're getting ready to set up shop. Second quarter, this defense looking for a big third down stop here. They're already down on the scoreboard, just trying to get the ball back to their offense. Meanwhile, on third down, they take a shot, but it's incomplete. So on now for the Packers at their all-time leading scorer, Mason Crosby. From the right hash, this from 45 yards away. And his kick is absolutely perfect. And the lead moves to 10-0. Time growing short here in this first half as they try to get some momentum heading into the lockers. Rodgers now on first down. And the result here, a pickup of 8. Leaves him with 2 to go on second down. There's a 2nd and 2 now from the 33.
Brings up 2nd and 2 at the 30.
Shotgun now for Rodgers. He'll let this go deep for Lazard. It's caught inside the 25. The Packers going to use one of their timeouts as the clock will stop with 55 seconds to go until halftime. So the big play gets them all the way down to the outskirts of the red zone here for 1st and 10. Now it's Rodgers. And it's intercepted at the goal line. Able to get there and pick it.
And this might not be the last interception we see, Brandon. Both of these teams like to throw the football, but here in this snow, ball's not going to always go where you want it to. And this one winds up getting intercepted.
And we shift to spotlighting. Time to jump back in. Opening drive, third quarter. And this offense has it in the red zone, first and 10. Oh, they'll try to jet sweep here with Lazard. And here he'll get it down to the 7. It's a 6-yard gain on the ground, and that'll make it 2nd and 4.
It's a pickup of 6. Brings up 2nd and 4 at the 7-yard.
Shotgun now for Rodgers. To the goal line, but it's incomplete.
Normally you think the tight end's going to be able to catch the football and handle that contact, but in this case, maybe a little too much target to hit. That one was timed well. Incomplete.
This will be the 8th play of the drive here. 3rd and 4.
45.
From the gun, it's Rodgers. Touchdown, Packers. Robert Tonyan there to make the grab. And the Packers are able to stretch that lead out further. Circle that drive, because that might be one to remember. Well executed to give him a little cushion.
Well, let's take it into the boxing ring. You talk about them commanding it, keeping the fight where they wanted to, whether it's in the center of the ring or putting them on the ropes, because there's jab, jab, jab. And finally, the haymaker to put that drive away.
Holding on to a slim 3-point lead here in the 4th. They need to hold on and hopefully yield no more than a field goal. On 2nd and 9, Brady looking sideline, incomplete. The Bucs on 3rd down. They've hit on half of them, 5 for 10. This is 3rd and 9. Shotgun now for Brady. And this is going to be incomplete. So on 4th down, out trots the kicker in a big spot here. Right hash, 37-yard attempt. And the 11-year veteran bangs it through. And in the 4th quarter, this game is tied.
17.
Well, this one's getting good now. 4th quarter, tie game. This defense looking for a huge 3rd down stop. And he's going to get this inside the 30. And this is good for a 1st down, his 2nd grab of this. Brady gives this one off to Jones. Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a 2nd and 9.
Well, sometimes you just have to give credit to the defense. Great job there at the point of attack, holding up. They won their battles at the line of scrimmage, left it no space to try and run. A really nice job swarming to the ball carrier.
He's got the 1st down inside the 10. He'll head out of bounds inside the 10. Mark him down at the 9. So it's Buccaneer football as we welcome you back. A game-winning field goal would be a chip shot from here. Let's see how they play it on 1st and goal. And the Buccaneers are going to be set up with a 1st and goal as good running gets them down to about the 4-yard line. So fresh out of the 2-minute warning, and here's another timeout taken with 1:55 remaining. Push his way forward down to about the 3-yard line. Now the Packers going to go ahead and use the 2nd of their timeouts as they'll talk it over here before what will be an important 3rd down. They'll try to run it in with Jones. That is not going to be any help as they dump him behind the line of scrimmage. So some pressure now on the kicker, Ryan Succop. This for the lead in the final stages. And Succop will put this one right through. And they have taken the lead here in the final 2 minutes.
17.
Now this offense in a spot where they need to work quickly and efficiently. They have no timeouts, down by three, hoping to get into field goal range. Now a throw right side taken in here to start this drive. And he takes this up to the 40-yard line before being corralled. They may want to go back to that one. First play of the drive, good for 15 and a first down. Now a desperation throw deep downfield. And it's incomplete. Boy, he doesn't drop many like that one. Second down.
Second and 10 at the 40-yard line.
To throw is Rodgers. It's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect. Now they face a third and 10 after back-to-back incompletions. He's back to throw. And he can't get a throw away. He's taken down. Lavonte David making his presence felt in the backfield.
Brings up fourth down.
They'll go for it. It's Rodgers. He's going to let it fly. And no, it's incomplete. They had to go for it with seven remaining. Really a great season. Not a whole lot to hang their head about.
Not at all. And, you know, the winning side, they're so ecstatic. They're going to the Super Bowl. But for the guys that we're talking about, they've got to figure out how it's going to go next year. Are they going to be motivated by this loss? Or will this loss linger and really make them, you know, make it tough for them to come out of the gates?
And that'll close the books on the conference championship. For Charles Davis, myself, Brandon Gordon, and our entire crew, we'll talk to you in 2 weeks from the Super Bowl. Between the Buffalo Bills and the Kansas City Chiefs. With Charles Davis, as always, I'm Brandon Gordon. Charles, you talk about storylines in this one. I think it begins and ends with our two quarterbacks, certainly two of the best in the business.
And nowadays, I don't think you can get by for long periods of time without a top-flight quarterback. The way the game is played, with all the responsibility he has and how the game flows through him, if he's not on the top of his game, your team's not going to benefit at all.
The Buffalo offense coming out, and it is Josh Allen who is at the helm.
How about 54 touchdown passes in two full seasons at the University of Wyoming? Coming out of a junior college, I think he exceeded expectations, and he can move it around a little bit too. A much better athlete than people give him credit for.
First carry for Devin Singletary, and he'll take it ahead to the 28-yard line. 4 yards the result on the first play from scrimmage. Second down. And Charles, despite this list of key inactives that we see here, they've obviously still been pretty successful.
Give everyone credit for this one, because to me, when that happens, key guys are out, the next man steps up and plays well. But that starts with the organization itself, all the way through. No excuses for guys being out. Finding guys who are capable backups who can step up and play when they need them. And we've seen the results of that. This team knows how to work through things.
And he fires one, but incomplete.
You tell they wanted to get that ball downfield, but had nothing working in the secondary, so he dropped it off to the running back. That one ended up incomplete.
Bohorquez on to punt as he gets it away. It was a 42, making a 43-yard punt. Six on the return, and it's Chiefs football, first and 10. So here are the Chiefs now under their veteran head coach, Andy Reid. They'll be led out by the MVP of the National Football League in 2018, the former Texas Tech Red Raider, Patrick Mahomes.
And Patrick Mahomes is back in this game for the third straight season, because you remember 2 years ago, they lost in overtime at home to New England, and then found their way through last year, beating Tennessee in the AFC title game in Kansas City as well. He has great experience in this game, understands how to win, and is eager to get a second straight Super Bowl title.
And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. Give him 13 yards on the opening play of the drive, and also give him a first down.
At the 43-yard line.
Shotgun snap to Mahomes. This pass going to be caught by Hardman. 7 yards, the pick up there. Able to get seven on that first down pass play. Second and three. Now an option play on second down. And good penetration here. He'll get this down only to about the 49-yard line. Give him a yard on the run there, and that's going to set up a third down and two. Here's Mahomes. Rush coming, and he's taken down. A.J. Klein in there to get him for a loss of 9 yards, and that also leads to fourth down.
It always helps for a visiting team to come in and set the tone on defense. In fact, when we talked with them prior to the game, they said they wanted this home crowd to feel like they had to hide their valuables when they were in town.
Well, the home crowd quiet now early. See if their offense can take over and get some points on the board. On fourth down, Tommy Townsend to punt for Kansas City. Andre Roberts is deep for Buffalo. They call that a punt of 38 yards officially. And the Bills will take over the football with a first and 10. Allen and the Bills now with a first and 10 at their own 22. A quick throw taken in by Diggs. A gain of 6 there on first. With these run-pass options, we often talk about a good quarterback and running back. Well, having a talented wide receiver helps also.
Yeah, even coming in third in the discussion, sometimes that means he really should be first, because all you want to do is get the ball in their hands and let them make the big plays downfield.
Give him 14 on that one, and a first down. That's his longest run of the first quarter. And Charles, we talked before the game about them needing to establish the run game. They'll be looking for more of that.
And they got to the perimeter. So that tells me that that's part of the game plan of what they wanted to get done today. So they'll have some complimentary runs where he'll run it to the inside. But it appears that when they want the big yardage, they think they can get to the outside and make it happen.
On first down, they stick with Singletary. And taking it across midfield and inside the 45. 15 more there, and they're on a roll. It's another first down. Well, they're making an effort to get the ground game going tonight. So far, it's working.
I like what we're seeing from the offensive line. They seem to have the leverage going, and they're controlling things and reestablishing the line of scrimmage, moving that defensive front backwards, but also like what the runner's giving us, too. It appears that he's been waiting all day long to get out here and take off.
So now first and 10 in Chiefs territory at the 42-yard line. It's Knox, the tight end, making the catch. And he's out of bounds. Almost gets to the 10. Give him 32 on the play.
And in the run-up to this championship game, so much was made about how would this offense hold up on the road in a hostile environment. Well, that's not the definitive answer, but what a great first answer from them, that big play right there.
So how about this for field position after the big play? Inside the 15 now as they come up on first and 10. Here's Allen. And that'll be knocked away. It's incomplete.
That's a nice job there because you've got to play the ball, not the man when in coverage. That'll keep you away from a lot of needless penalties. And he's able to knock that one away.
And we'll get this one down to about the 10-yard line. They do get a yard there, but only a yard. Leaves him with third and 9 looming.
Brandon, we talk all the time about those hybrid players, guys who can do more than one thing. And I think if you're playing strong safety in the NFL today, you are a true hybrid. Punt linebacker, punt cover guy.
And coming up, sticking his nose in the mess there and making a nice play defensively. The Kansas City defense, tough to throw on there. And now it's fourth down. The kick by Bass is good. And the Bills will take a 3-0 lead.
Chiefs, nothing.
So still no touchdowns in the first half, but we do have some action on the scoreboard with the field goal.
So maybe now the mentality changes in this game because anytime you can get to the red zone and if you don't come away with 6 points, you feel like it's a disappointment. In a game like this one, being able to kick field goals means you're right there and then you're just looking for that big break to take you over the top.
Mahomes will lead the Chiefs up first and 10 at their 25-yard line. The first running back drafted in April, this is Clyde Edwards-Helaire. And they'll get it all the way up about 5 yards shy of midfield.
That's good.
And that one heck of a run right there. Once he got loose, you could tell that he was going to run a long way. That was pretty impressive. And they'll let the quarterback keep it here on first and 10. And he'll take it across midfield and into Buffalo territory. A solid run on first down. Gain of 7 leaves him with a 2nd and 3.
Brings up 2nd and 3.
From the gun, it's Mahomes. Over the middle, he's got Watkins. And he'll be brought down. Looks like right at the 40. Tally, that is catch number 1 for him in this AFC Championship. It's a first down.
First and 10 at the 40-yard line.
Now Edwards-Helaire. And a short gain there down to the 37-yard line.
Not the kind of gain that we'll go absolutely crazy for, but it's the kind of gain that you need to have when you're running back in the NFL and Clyde Edwards-Helaire with that low center of gravity and strength. He's going to get those tough, gritty yards for you when necessary.
And that is incomplete. A lot of force bearing down on him there. He could not hang on. It's 3rd down.
Tremendous field position there and a perfect time to do exactly what they did. Take a shot at the end zone. And they went for the big play, just unable to complete it.
Throwing is Mahomes on 3rd. And he's got his man out of the backfield. That's complete. And a good job defensively. They stop him short of the first at the 32. Instead of throwing it downfield, Charles, they just tried to dump it underneath there. You like the call?
I do. I think it's a high percentage play because you get the completion. What you're counting on is your back to use his legs and his elusiveness to make people miss and pick up the first down. In this case, it didn't happen.
And they move this all the way down to the 9. Wow, 1st and goal, and defensively, all they can do is shake their heads. Not only did they allow the conversion, but a big play as well. Working from the gun, Mahomes. Looking end zone, but it's incomplete.
To this point, I've been impressed with the work defensively. They have not allowed a lot of receivers to run free. And there's another example, another incompletion.
On 2nd and goal, Mahomes. And he takes this out of the end zone for a Chiefs touchdown. A 9-yard touchdown grab. And the Chiefs have taken the lead.
And that drive we just saw that culminated in a touchdown, exactly what many offenses are looking for. Sustained ones that can impose their will on the other team.
on for the extra point. And this is up and good to make it 7-3. A good drive that time as they go 9 plays in all. And it winds up with the Chiefs hitting pay dirt. Now after the touchdown, here's Butker on to kick it away. Make it to the 25.
Turns on the return. The Bills take over first and 10 at their own 24-yard line.
Buffalo is set to get the football back here. Their drive last time, it stalled out. They were forced to take the short field goal.
And the key phrase, you nailed it. Forced to, because you know coaches look at these short field goals as a last resort, right? To them, that's not how drives are supposed to end. You're supposed to put 6 on the board. That's a consolation prize. Like going to the county fair, you don't get the big stuffed animal on that one, do you?
No, you don't go top shelf. That's bottom shelf material. A second down pass play there, but it's incomplete. And a reminder, folks, as we've done all year, we'll send you to Orlando for our EA Sports Halftime Report coming up shortly. The coach with us, as always, as he will start to look ahead to Super Bowl 53. And able to rip off a big chunk of yardage before being dropped inside the 40. A first down and then some, 36 yards.
I think it's pretty safe to say that initially they had to be thinking about trying to get into field goal range. But after that shot right there, they've got to be thinking bigger right now.
And that was probably their thought offensively. If we hit this, great, let's go for the end zone. If not, settle for a field goal. Looks like they can try to hit pay dirt. He'll try and fire this downfield for some. And this is caught. And they are able to stop him, but he does take it all the way to the 2. That one good for 37 yards. Well, make that hit 2 completions for him on this drive. And these aren't ordinary completions, they're big ones.
Yeah, these are the types that make a secondary talk to each other and not in a good way. Oftentimes pointing fingers. Hey, who's got him? Someone cover him. That type of indecision can open up to even more big plays.
So it's first and goal, and a great opportunity to get that lead back before the break. They'll look to run with Singletary, and he'll go backwards, losing yardage to the 5. A loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's second down. To the air, Allen. Under pressure, down he goes. Sacked at the 10. A CD, you know, so often we talk about quarterbacks holding on to the ball too long. Well, we can't say that there. He had no time to do much of anything. Dancing to his left. He may try. And he is into the end zone for a Buffalo touchdown.
Good job.
A 10-yard touchdown run. And the Bills have retaken the lead.
That's a tough one there defensively, because look at the stops they got on first and second down. And it's first and second and goal. And then on third down, they cover the receivers, but they leave an alley open for him to find, and he does. That is frustrating. You do almost everything right, and he still ends up in the end zone.
And it's through, and that makes the lead 10-7. So that winds up a 7-play drive all told. And it was Josh Allen using his legs to polish things off. After the touchdown, Bass to kick it away. That's fielded on the back line of the end zone. And not wanting to risk anything here late in the half, he'll just take a knee and they'll bring the football out to the 25. A little under 30 seconds to go. We'll see how they play it here on first and 10. Throwing now is Mahomes. He's going to look deep for Watkins. And that will be incomplete. Would have been a big hitter if they had connected. Instead, it's second down. Second and 10, a very chilly day here, but no snow. And I got to say, if it's going to be this cold, I want snow. You should see Charles' face. He's looking at me like I'm crazy. And he takes us beyond the 35 before going out of bounds. Going open downfield, he keeps it himself for 11 and a first down.
First and 10 at the 36-yard line.
Here's Mahomes to throw. Complete, the tight end Kelce. And he's going to be taken down here with a penalty flag on the field. So a decent gain, but all for naught on the penalty.
That's too bad, isn't it? They were feeling pretty good about it. The only people celebrating, the guys who just gave up that play.
To throw, it's Mahomes. He'll find his tight end, Seals Jones. And with just 4 seconds left in this first half, a timeout call. Final shot before the half from Mahomes. He'll let this go for the end zone. And that is incomplete. So we are halfway home to figuring out who will represent the AFC in the Super Bowl. As we send you down to Orlando, where Jonathan Coachman has our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach.
All right, Brandon, thanks as always. One half remains in the battle to see who will take home the Lamar Hunt Trophy and represent the AFC in the Super Bowl. We'll get back to you guys in just a moment. But first, let's look back to the NFC Championship game held earlier today. And it is the Green Bay Packers are heading back to the Super Bowl as they await the winner of this AFC Championship game. So with that, let's get you right back out for the second half and the right to represent the AFC in the Super Bowl, as I'm privileged to hand things back over to Brandon Godden.
Thank you, sir. A field goal separates these two teams as we come back for this second half. One more half to decide who takes home the Lamar Hunt Trophy as we're back underway in this AFC Championship. That's fielded on the back line of the end zone. And Hardman going to go ahead and sit on this one as it'll come out to the 25. The Chiefs offense about set to begin this drive. And both of these defenses have been stifling these last few drives offensively. Just not able to get anything going. So what needs to change?
And a lot of the guys will go back and review, so to speak, because everyone has someone assigned to. How did each play work? Okay, what did we use that kind of worked for us during this game? Try and get back to some of those plays, as well as the possibility of showing something you haven't shown already in this game and trying to change things up.
We'll see if they take the advice of Mr. Davis. Now a man open down the middle of the field. And they'll get it up just short of the 45 at the 44. Just his second catch of the game so far. This one moves the chains.
First and 10 at the 44-yard line.
Throwing on first down is Mahomes. Completes it to Hardman. And he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50. Right back to him for 10 more and a first. So first and 10 now in Buffalo territory at the 46. To the right side, it's Kelsey. And he'll go down. Shy of the 40 at the 41. Second and 5 after the 5-yard completion on first down. Now it's Mahomes again. Caught, Kelsey, left side. Only 3 yards on the catch. It's third down.
Well, they're unable to convert that into much, but it's never a bad idea to try to get the ball into a tight end of his caliber's hands and see what kind of disruption he can cause.
They'll try and run for it with Bell. And the lane closes quickly for Bell, and he did not make it. That'll make it fourth down after a loss of one. Field goal would have been a decent length at 55 yards. They keep the kicking unit on the sideline. They're going for it. They'll go for it with Bell. And boy, is he close. Did he get there? No, they're going to say he's short of the line to gain. Le'Veon Bell stops short of the line to gain. And the Bills are going to get the football back. Singletary to get the drive started. And he will lose yardage back to the 34-yard line. 2 yards the loss, second and 12. For the opening play of the drive goes backwards. Now they'll come up on second and 12. A play fake to Singletary, and now it's Allen going deep for Diggs. Into double coverage, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Juan Thornhill. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back.
Well, it's a cold night, and whether you're a quarterback that wears a glove on his throwing hand or not, that ball is a rock, Brandon. You've got to really drive it through the cold and the wind, or it can take off on you, and that may have been what happened there.
KC's offense ready to take over. And this offense last time turned it over, went for it on fourth, didn't get it. They're lucky, though, because no points against the team on the board, but we'll see how they respond.
Yeah, they've got to get a lot of credit to their defensive teammates, don't they? They had their backs on that last series, and because they did so, that allows the coach to still stay aggressive on offense and maybe go for it again in a similar situation.
I was going to say, maybe makes that offense feel good when you know you've got a defense making stands like that.
Yeah, that'll loosen up things a little bit, won't it? Maybe you'll play a little bit better the next time you have the ball.
But now a throw on first down there, but it's incomplete. He was looking for his tight end, Kelsey, and now it's second down.
It's now second and 10.
From the shotgun, it's a give to Bell. 9 yards, and that leaves him just short, so it'll be third and less than a yard.
The 44-yard line brings up third down.
Edwards-Helaire, they'll try to run for it. And he brings this up to the 46, good enough for the first. There'll be a pickup of just two, and the Chiefs are going to get a fresh set of downs.
And that's why you spend a first-round draft pick on a running back, not for just the fancy runs, but these dirty, gritty third and ones, third and twos. That's why you draft him.
Mahomes firing complete. Tackled inside the 40, not quite to the 35. First down for the Chiefs. Solid chunk of yardage, 17 on the play.
First and 10 at the 37-yard line.
1 quarter remains for the right to go on to the Super Bowl. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10. Now Mahomes. A screen to Bell. And they'll get him down after a pickup of 8. Second and 2.
For a second there, I thought that might break big. Screen pass. Looked like it was coming together. Looked like there was an opening. Still, ended up with a solid game.
A short gain here, maybe a yard to the 29.
Trent Murphy made the tackle. It's a gain of a yard.
The Chiefs on third down. They've only converted once in 4 tries. Here it's third and 2. They'll run. It's Edwards-Helaire. Well, this is going to depend on the spot, but it's not a very generous one. He looks to be about a yard or so short.
Well, they picked up a portion of it, but not all that they needed. Now that leads to a decision on fourth and 1. Let's see what they decide to do.
And this one looks good. It is good. Right down the pipe. And in the fourth quarter, this game is tied. I tell you, the life of a kicker. He has not been called on the entire game. He's over there by the net. But they send him out here in the fourth quarter and say, hey, go tie the game, will you? And guess what? He comes through.
I just don't know how they do it. I really don't. These cats are a different breed from you and me. That's a pressure kick, but that one was never in doubt.
At their own 19-yard line.
The Bills come to the line to start their next drive. And this one likely on the short list for Game of the Year candidates. And boy, did it come in a good one here in the playoffs. All tied in the fourth with a berth to the Super Bowl on the line. Buckle up, everybody. It's a 7-yard carry to set them up with a 2nd and 3.
Second and 3.
So they fake the handoff. Now Allen, he's going to float this one deep. Oh, this is taken in. It's complete. And all the way inside the 35 before he goes out of bounds. I think it's fair to say there's nothing that gets a crowd to its feet quite like a big play, and that was something special there. Boy, was he moving.
Well, in this league where coordinators worry so much about drawing up the right routes, blocking assignments, misdirections and stuff, they have these precise arrows and movements. Sometimes the best plays just come from the schoolyard where you look at your fastest guy and say, go long, go get it, big man.
And according to Next Gen Stats, his top speed on that one, better than 20 miles an hour. So the big play changes the complexion of things. Here's first and 10 just outside the 30. Singletary here running out of the gun. And he'll get a little over 2, maybe a full 3 down to the 32-yard line.
Well, any lane that might have been lineman open there was closed pretty quickly, and that was because the defensive front, they won that battle at the point of attack at the line of scrimmage.
Oh, no, he lost the football. And the ball ends up out of bounds, so it'll be a loss on the play.
You can almost see inside his face mask there, the look of relief. He coughed it up, but it goes out of bounds. They keep it.
Someone carrying around the lucky horseshoe, aren't they? If I were him, I'd go out and play the lottery after that one. A very fortunate man.
And they're operating in plus territory here. They're thinking points. Definitely don't want to lose the football at this juncture. And he is going to have a Bills first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. Getting 22 there on the third down conversion.
And partner, the tie game in the fourth quarter. In the NFL, that's when you lean on your stars, and he came through with a nice catch right there.
From the 13 now, they work on first and 10. From the red zone now, they'll look to throw. His pass caught at the 4. And he'll take it into the end zone for a Buffalo touchdown. From 13 yards out, and the Bills have broken the tie. And on that one, able to catch it, also able to have the wherewithal to take it in for the score.
And how about the phases of a successful catch and a completion of a play? Look the ball in, secure the catch, and then, of course, the run after the catch that ends up in the end zone.
He's got it as they go up by a total of 17 to 10. A drive that time of 6 plays, and it ends in a Buffalo touchdown. After the touchdown, Bass to kick it away. Taken about 7 yards deep. And bring this out to the 25. No return there for Hardman. Patrick Mahomes on his way out for their next drive. So the situation, very simple here. Late game, down 7. They've got to get it in the end zone.
And the best players know how to be calm in these situations, because you know right now his pulse is like a jackhammer. So how does he rein it in, make sure the team has a little bit of calm, coupled with that sense of urgency, got to walk that line a little bit, but get it downfield in order to score, and then put the pressure on the guy who kicks the ball, because he could tie the game.
It's been a fun game. It all comes down to this. Mahomes will try again on second down. This pass going to be caught by Hardman. He'll be dropped after a gain of about 6 across the 30 to the 31. They get 6. That'll leave them with 3rd and 4. Fourth quarter, down to the final 2 minutes, and we've got a 1-score game. So the Chiefs in possession of the ball as we welcome you back. They face a critical third down now, needing a score here in the late going. And that is incomplete.
They'll probably spend a little extra time dissecting the game film after this one. I think the part of their plan was to hit them over the top of the deep ball. They've been unsuccessful all night.
They'll go for it. It's Mahomes. He is going to find Hill here. And he's got the first before he's brought down at the 39-yard line. And the drive stays in motion with a nice 8-yard pickup. And this will be caught at the 30. And he'll go down, but not before getting this inside the 30. 33 yards that time.
Okay, there's 3 timeouts left, right?
Think you got to use one here, don't you?
No doubt about it. I'd use one right here.
This will be stopped about 2 yards shy of the marker. 8-yard gain, 2nd and 2. Clock's under a minute. Still plenty of time, partner. They have all 3 timeouts.
That means they have plenty of options in their play calling and where they target on the field. They can throw it downfield, maybe even in the middle, and use their timeouts.
To throw is Mahomes. That one complete to Hill. And he will have a Chiefs first down as this defense unable to hold. It's a 7-yard gain there on 3rd and 2.
I'm a little surprised right here. They've got 3 timeouts left. The clock's running down, and they aren't using them. Those timeouts do you no good at home. Use them now.
The Chiefs now going to use the first of their timeouts as they get it right at the 32nd mark of this fourth quarter. And he can't get a throw off. He's taken down. What a huge play at this point in the game. Jerry Hughes in there to drop him as that clock continues to run. And, oh, a crusher there as it's intercepted. Picked off by Jordan Poyer.
They'll take over first and 10 at their own 20-yard line.
We'll see if they want to use them. And now with 4 seconds left, we get a timeout call. And they take a knee, and a timeout comes in. The whistles blow with 3 seconds remaining. So time to start going in the other direction as they come up now, third and long. And they will take a knee here.
The Bills are going to the Super Bowl as we say goodnight, everybody.
And that does it for the conference championship. For Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gauden. And for our entire crew, we'll see you 2 weeks at the Super Bowl. This is the NFL on EA Sports.